If you understand how to read your Fiverr analytics, you'll never be left wondering why your gig isn't selling, because the data literally tells you what to fix. And most freelancers never figure this out. They launch a gig, wait around, get frustrated when nothing happens, and then either blame the algorithm or quit altogether. But what if I told you there's a way to see exactly why your gig isn't working and what to do about it? And in this video, I'm going to show you how to decode Fiverr's analytics dashboard so that you can stop guessing and actually start growing. So let's start things off with something I see all the time. Someone launches a Fiverr gig. It looks decent. They wait a week and what happens? No orders. So they start panicking, or they assume Fiverr's hiding their gig on purpose. Sound familiar? Well, if it doesn't, then all you have to do is go and check all of my comments on my videos and you'll see that it's a pretty common trend on how people think. But the thing what they're not doing is looking at the analytics that Fiverr gives them. And that's the mistake, because Fiverr's analytics dashboard is one of the most underused tools on the platform. It shows you how many people are seeing your gig, how many are clicking, and how many are actually ordering. But more importantly, it tells you where the problem is. Is it your visibility? Is it your thumbnails? Is it your pricing? The data quite literally gives you these clues, and I'm going to show you how to decipher them so that you're no longer left in the dark. So let's go ahead and break it down step by step. First, we have impressions, and this is always going to be your biggest number. Impressions are simply how many times your gig is showed up in search results. That's it. Someone searched a keyword, Fiverr showed your gig on the list, and it counted as an impression. And that doesn't matter whether they noticed you or just scrolled right over you. Now, if you're new to Fiverr, your impressions are going to be low. And that's completely normal, because with a brand new gig, where do you think Fiverr positions you? I'll give you a clue. It's not going to be on the first page. No. You're buried behind more established sellers, probably on page 20. And don't let that stress you out, because it's completely normal for you to be sitting back there for the first week or two. But if your impressions stay low over time, like 2 or 3 weeks in, you've got a visibility problem. And that usually comes down to SEO. And what's Fiverr SEO, you ask? Well, it's your title, your tags, and your category. They tell Fiverr where to place your gig. And if your title doesn't match buyer intent, or if your tags are random, or if you choose the wrong subcategory, Fiverr literally doesn't know where to show you. And if Fiverr doesn't know who your gig is for, then it's not going to show you to anyone. So low impressions over 2 to 3 weeks means you've got an SEO problem. Now, let's talk about clicks, because this is where most sellers get it wrong. Clicks are way more important than impressions. Why? Because impressions are passive. They just mean that your gig has appeared on a screen, but clicks now show intent. Someone saw your gig and thought it was worth exploring. And let me give you some context for this. I get around 20,000 impressions a week across my whole profile, but only 400 of those turn into clicks. And that's normal. It's the same with top sellers across every category. So if you're stuck focusing on getting 100,000 impressions, you're playing the wrong game. You want more clicks, not just more eyeballs. And your click-through rate comes down to just 3 things: your title, your thumbnail, and your price. That's all buyers are seeing before they decide to click or not. So those 3 things need to hit hard. And if we break them down, then it's going to look something like this. First, your title. Is it clear? Is it specific? Does it speak to what the buyer actually wants? Titles like high quality logo design is just too vague. Modern minimalistic logo design for startups is better and also more targeted. Second, thumbnail. Does it stand out visually? Is it readable in a small format when scrolling over gigs? Does it give an instant sense of quality or uniqueness? And three, price. Are you positioned right for your market? Too cheap and you look inexperienced. Too expensive, and you risk losing trust if your gig doesn't back it up. So if your click-through rate is low, tweak those three things, but test one change at a time and track what happens, as it could just be one of those three things actually holding you back. Now, let's say someone clicks in your gig. That means you've won their attention, so congratulations. Now, you have to convert them. This is where your gallery, your gig description, and your packages come into play. The gallery will consist of things like your images, your video, your work samples. This is your social proof. It shows quality without needing words. If it looks average, buyers will of course just bounce off. The aim here is to sell yourself in a visual way with enough understanding that the buyer will know exactly what they're looking at. Next is your pricing packages. Now, are your packages structured clearly? Is there an obvious difference between basic, standard, and premium? Are you solving a problem for people or just listing deliverables? Then they'll scroll down to find your gig description. Now, this is where the trust is built even further. This is where every single buyer will get the clarity that they need to just understand your gig better. So talk to the buyer's problems, explain your process, and list exactly what they'll get in each package you offer. If they get confused, they're gone. And when you get this part right, it means that buyers won't even need to message you. They'll just go ahead and place an order. So here's how to use Fiverr Analytics properly. Low impressions equals fix your SEO, meaning titles, tags, and category. Low clicks, tweak your title, thumbnail, or price. Low conversions, improve your gallery, pricing layout, and gig description. This data is simple, clear, and measurable. Plus, you can check all of this inside your analytics dashboard. Now, my advice would be to track your numbers weekly. Don't just guess and don't wait 3 months to make a change. You could even set a reminder to log your impressions, clicks, and orders for each gig every Sunday. And after 2 or 3 weeks, you will start to see some patterns. And that's how you turn a dead gig into one that actually starts generating consistent orders. Now, a few quick bonus tips while we're here. Number one, change one thing at a time. If you update your thumbnail, don't also change your price and description. Otherwise, you won't know what worked. Second, don't run Fiverr ads. If you have a new gig and think you're gonna run Fiverr ads to increase impressions and get more orders, then you're wrong. As I guarantee, all you'll do is spend money with very little return on your investment. Third, keep records. Now, Fiverr doesn't show historical CTR trends. So screenshot or log your data somewhere. This then becomes your growth dashboard over time. So just to recap, impressions, show your visibility. Clicks, show your curiosity factor. Orders, show your trust factor. Fiverr is giving you all of this information that you need to fix underperforming gigs. You just need to learn how to read it properly and, of course, act on it. And remember, if you understand how to read your Fiverr analytics, you'll never be left wondering why your gig isn't selling, because the data literally tells you what to fix. And if you do need more help, then check out my 14-day Freelancer Accelerator program linked in the description, where we'll work together one-on-one. All the details are in the link, so you can go check them out. Otherwise, this video right here should be the next one that you go and watch according to YouTube.